over the last year, I've been taking YouTube more serious. That means I've been making a lot more videos, which is good for you guys. But for myself, I've been running into one major issue, which is storage. Consistently, I've been purchasing many of these external hard drives. And even if I use something like iCloud, it just becomes very cost effective, especially producing high quality 4K videos. That's when I discovered UGREEN NAS storage system. I saw this being publicized all over social media, and it ticked off the boxes of items that I needed in my own system. So it was cost effective, it had a ton of features, but more importantly for me, it allowed me to have my own private cloud. And I was also familiar with the brand since I've purchased many of their charging stations. I've actually have a video of my premium tech travel essentials. I'll have the links down in the description below for you guys to watch that. But if you are new here, hey there, I'm Alex Robinson. I do tech review and just essential tech items that you could put in your everyday life. So what exactly is UGREEN NAS? NAS stands for Network Attached Storage, and I want you guys to think about that as a cloud service, something similar to Google Drive or even iCloud. However, you have full control over the physical data, which is a game changer, especially for those of you who want to level up your storage experience or even just don't want to be limited by the limitations of using your iCloud or even Google Drive. The setup process for this was very straightforward, and I like that, especially when using complex hardware and softwares like this. So it comes with Intel Premium Gold processor with 5 cores, 6 threads, and 440 gigahertz, and I believe this is at max turbo, along with 8 gigabit of DDR5 RAM and a pre-installed 128 SSD UGREEN Pro for the operating system. Installation was easy, no tools required, just pop the drives in and you're good to go. The NAS even has slots for M.2 NVMe drives if you want faster storage options for caching. I don't even have that installed, but I want to be able to do that in the future. And if you guys subscribe to this channel, I'll be able to even get more revenue to do things like this. I installed 2 4-terabyte drives, even though the base supports up to 4, and I've seen over the internet where folks are making the recommendation that you should just purchase all of the drives at once and install them, simply because of the time that it takes to build up the system. But hear me out, I'm on a budget and I have 2 4-terabyte drives. Maybe by next Amazon Prime Day, I'll pick up around 4 20-terabyte drives. Now, once I downloaded the UGREEN app, it was able to guide me through the setup process, which was pretty simple. For these 2 drives that I have installed, I have them set up into the RAID configuration, which pretty much means that one drive acts as a backup to the next. So if the primary drive fails of this corruption of data, the data has already been stored on the secondary drive. And the whole process, even to do the security checks on the drives and make sure that the health of all of these drives were good, took a couple hours. I believe more than 5 hours. And I must say, even interacting with the UI and looking at the physical components of this NAS system, it just screams minimalistic and also just feels like it would fit perfectly into the Apple ecosystem. This NAS supports up to 112 terabytes of storage. That is a ton of storage. But if you're someone that just wants to save your pictures and your videos or even your documents, this might seem a lot to you, and to be honest, it is probably an overkill. But for someone like me that records most of my content in 4K, this will be able to handle all of this for a long period of time. The ports on these are blazing fast for connectivity, giving you a 2.5 and a 10 gigabit LAN ports. And it doesn't make sense that you have something like this and the speeds of transfer are slow, but this will allow you to have fast speeds. And then along with that, we have a Type-C Gen 2 port and a USB 3.2 port for speeds up to 10 gigabits per second, and also a 4K 60 hertz HDMI port. One of the beauty of this thing is that you're able to access your data from anywhere. iOS, Android, or even from your laptop, you could just pull up a web browser and log into this device, and you're able to access your data right there on your fingertip. And this is one of the beauty of having your own private cloud. And even for an extra level of protection, I have two-factor authentication enabled when I'm actually logging into this device. But it just makes me feel so much better knowing that my data is privately secured in my own cloud. This to me is just a better solution than using something like an iCloud. Imagine you're paying around $9 a month for around 2 terabytes of storage. That's around $120 for the year. And you could have for this device, which is a one-time payment, which is just pretty easy to set up and have all of your data in one place. And one of the things that I've mentioned to you that I hate about Apple is that if you forget to even make a payment, they hold you hostage to your own data. Who knows what actually happens when you send your data to one of those cloud servers that are out there, which AI is being trained on your own data, and not even sometimes a little compensation of your own data being used to train AI. And that's just one of the beauty of knowing that your data is with you at all times, or in your possession at all times. And also for scalability reasons, you could also quickly scale up your storage on this. Just makes it easier for you, just pop a drive in once you need to scale up in the storage on this device. If you're constantly running out of storage, and if you're like me that you consistently purchase those external hard drives every couple months, maybe you should consider picking up a NAS storage system like this one, or even with the competitors that are out there. I really don't know much about the competitors. I've seen so much, but the prices are a little bit higher than this, and just the features and the cost efficiency that I've said that you get from the UGREEN NAS storage system is kind of why I got this particular one. But I feel like that wraps it up for this video. If you see what you like so far, make sure that you like this video and share your thoughts in the comment section below. I'm curious to hear what NAS storage system that you guys have, or if you'll be picking up this particular one. Let me know in the comment section below. And I feel like that wraps it up. Peace out, God bless, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.